So this is a question which has come in JEE Advanced. So let us discuss this. Here we have gas which is moving, the gas molecules are moving with very high speed, which is u, and they are moving randomly. So for the purpose of collisions, either we can say that the collision is with the molecules which are having the velocity perpendicular to the this plate, or we can also talk about those molecules which have their velocity right now at an angle theta. The only difference is that, like, if you consider the molecule to be moving in this way, and then they will be going in opposite direction after collision with the wall, then this u will become some new velocity. Whereas in this case, what will happen is, if you say that, okay, this gas molecules are moving at an angle theta, then you can say that, okay, there are two component of velocities, and only this u cos theta will become something else. So only a cos theta factor will be coming. Okay, so let us consider those molecules which are moving right now directly towards the wall, which means perpendicular to the wall, and the wall is moving with velocity v. Okay, now let's say the wall has area A, and let us assume that molecules are moving towards the wall only. Anyway, we are interested in those molecules of which are moving towards the wall, and not on those molecules which are moving away from the wall. Let's say n is the number of molecules per unit volume that are moving towards the wall. Because the entire gas is like uniform, so we can say that within each unit volume there will be same n number of molecules which may be moving towards the wall, which is n here. Okay, now what is the change in momentum these molecules are going to have after elastic collision? So the wall is also moving towards the molecule with velocity v. So v approach is equal to v plus u, and after collision the wall's velocity is maintained. Okay, even when it may get a force from the colliding molecules, we are applying an external force so that it overall moves with a constant velocity v. So let us say that after collision this molecule moves backwards from where it came with a velocity u dash. So in which case v separation will be equal to u dash minus v. So we know that because the collision is elastic, approach velocity is equal to separation velocity. So u dash is equal to 2v plus u. Let us try to understand how much is the change in momentum. So change in momentum of the molecule will be equal to final momentum minus initial momentum. Final momentum of this molecule, if it's having a mass m, 2v plus u i cap minus the initial momentum. Okay, what is the initial momentum here? Initial momentum is u in minus i. Mass will also be there. So m 2m v plus u in i cap, which means each molecule after colliding with this wall will have a change in momentum in ground frame of reference of value 2m into v plus u. Now let us try to understand how many molecules will be colliding, okay, with this wall per unit time. Okay, let's go back. What we'll do is we'll copy this diagram once. What we are going to do is we are going to consider some cuboidal element, and this cuboidal element we are taking of length v plus u dt. Okay, and we are going to say that whatever are the molecules within this volume which are moving towards the wall will be able to collide. Why? Because these are going to collide in dt time. How much will be the displacement of the wall in dt time? So displacement of the wall will be v dt. And so if the displacement of the wall is v dt, then the wall itself will be going forward. So this point of the wall, which is A, in dt time, it will come to this point A dash, and it will travel a distance of v dt. And like that, this B point will also shift to B dash. VDT. So the entire wall will come here, and this is VDT. Now, what is the other volume? Other volume is this UDT into the area. Now, what you can say is, whatever molecules are there in this volume, they are moving towards the wall. Definitely, they are going to collide with the wall because they are also moving towards the wall, and wall is also moving towards them. Not only that, even if you take a molecule, which is, let's say, at this point here, let's call this molecule as molecule P. This total distance is U plus V dt. Now, this gas molecule has a speed U, and this wall has a speed V. So in dt time, together they will come close to each other by amount of U plus V dt, and so they will collide. Why? Because in dt time they can cover a distance all the way up to U plus V dt, but their present distance is less than U plus V dt. Only if you consider a molecule outside this cuboidal volume, maybe here, where this distance is greater than U plus V dt, then this molecule is already at a distance larger than U plus V dt from the wall, and in dt time, even if this molecule is moving towards the wall, the distance between them is going to decrease only by amount U plus V dt, but their present distance is greater than U plus V dt, and so they will not be able to collide with the wall. So only those molecules which are moving towards the wall and they are within this volume of U plus V dt into this front area, this green front area A. So only those molecules will be able to collide. And how many such molecules are there? So number of molecules per unit volume which are moving towards the wall is N into the volume. How much volume we are considering? This. So these are the number of collisions in dt time. Now, what is the number of collisions per unit time? So that will be number of collisions per unit time is U plus V into N into A. Then what is the total change in momentum of all the gas molecules per unit time? Total change in momentum per unit time, which is rate of change of momentum, is equal to change in momentum of one molecule multiplied by how many molecules are colliding with the wall per unit time. So in unit time, the number of molecules colliding is this, and each of those molecules are going to have a change in momentum of, we have already found out, 2m u plus v I cap. And so we will get the rate of change of momentum of these molecules to be into A into N. And this is also the force on the molecules. If this is the force on the molecules from the wall, because wall is the thing which is changing their momentum, so wall will also get the same force from the molecules because of Newton's third law. So what you will get is, this wall is will be getting a backward force from the molecules which are in the front of it by an amount roughly equal to this U plus V whole square. Now you may say that, okay, why you have considered the molecules to be moving perpendicular? Why not you have considered the molecules which are moving at an angle theta? In that case, the only difference that will be coming is like cos component. You have to take the velocity's cos component, nothing else changes. Okay, so this U will become actually this U cos theta. So no need to bother much about that. Okay, or you can take some average values also. Now similarly, if the same exercise you do for the molecules which are behind the wall, and the wall is moving with velocity V, and these molecules are moving with a very large velocity U, and U is much greater than V, then what you will get is, when these molecules, they move towards right and collide with the wall and then go back, during that time they will exert a force, and this time the expression will come out to be U minus V. Now here I have not used the concept of thrust force or this variable mass system, but you can do it using variable mass system also. That is very simple, like m dot into v relative is the threat force. By using simply that, you will be able to calculate very easily what is the force. So rather than applying a ready-made formula, I have actually derived it. Okay, so what is the net force? Net force is 2mNa u plus v whole square minus of u minus v whole square. So the entire force that this flat plate is getting due to collisions will come out to be proportional to some u into v, because this will be like 4uv kind of thing. So let us see the options. Now the pressure difference, this is the force per unit area. This is force only. So force divided by area will be this pressure. So on one side the pressure will be proportional to u plus v whole square, on other side the pressure will be proportional to u minus v whole square, and when you take the pressure difference, then the pressure difference will be proportional to u into v, which is actually the option number fourth is this only. So this is correct option. Now at later instants of time, external force balances resistive force. This resistive force is nothing but the pressure difference force only, which is exerted by the gas molecules due to collision. So initially what will happen is, let's say this velocity is very low and the force that we are applying is quite large. So what will happen is this velocity keeps increasing, and you can say that how much is the opposing force? Opposing force is equal to or is proportional to uv. U is anyway constant, which is the random motion velocity of the gases. So opposing force is proportional to v. It is like a drag force which is proportional to v, and you know that in case of drag force proportional to v, the things are like a terminal velocity is reached when the external driving force becomes equal to the resistive force. So that viscosity concept you will already be knowing. So this is also correct. The plate will continue to move with constant non-zero acceleration at all times. So that is wrong, because the acceleration will keep changing, because the opposing force from the gas molecules due to collision will keep changing with the velocity, and it will move with constant velocity ultimately, so its acceleration will become zero finally. And the resistive force experienced by the plate is proportional to V. So that we have already discussed is to be true. So this is also correct. So answer is ACD.